day. What a day. Seymour, you mind locking up for me? I'm all in.
1 second, Audrey. I want to show you something. I
can't wait until tomorrow.
It won't take long. I went shopping for a new wardrobe like you told me to, and ta-da! What do you think?
Seymour.
You don't like it.
I don't know.
Oh, I'll take it off. I'll take it back. Oh, I'll burn it. Back is on dry.
I don't know what's come over me. I guess I've been feeling a little under the weather lately.
It's Oren, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved as when they told me he'd gone missing. It was a miracle. Not to mention all the money I've saved on Epsom salts and these bandages.
Then what's the matter?
I feel guilty. I mean, if he did meet with some sort of accident, then you see, it's partly my fault, because, secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, you shouldn't waste one more minute thinking about that creep. There's a lot of guys who'd go out with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Please don't.
I deserve a creep like Orange Crivello DDS. You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
Gutter. It's a night spot. I used to work there when we weren't making much money. I'd put on some low and tasteless outfit. Not nice ones like these, and low and nasty apparel,
oh,
and I...
That's all behind you now. You've got nothing to be ashamed of. You're a very nice girl, and I always knew that. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs. You know what I saw? Girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wipe off that mascara. Here, take my Kleenex. Wipe that lipstick away. It's so